So, Spider-Man came out earlier this week. As of when I'm recording this, the movie isn't out yet, but I hope you enjoyed or enjoy it. Anyway, you probably don't want to be bitten by a radioactive version of any of these spiders. With that being said, here is all canon arachnids explained. Let's face it, there's probably more arachnid species than are present on this list. I'm just going off of what Wikipedia have on their arachnids category. First up is the ambush spider, a type of giant spider native to the planet Lekkar that lived under the canopies of forests and jungles. Next is assassin spiders. These spiders had a phosphorescent skull pattern on their thorax. They are native to the planet Taris and could spit venom. Now for baneback spiders, the large arachnids native to Dathomir. They were hostile and could spit poisonous saliva at enemies. Although their hostile nature, baneback spiders were domesticated by the Knight Brothers, who captured young spiders and raised them. Next up is combat arachnids. These were from the planet Carida and were covered in reflective spines, had pointy legs, sharp fangs, sharp barbs on their lower abdomens, and were bantha-sized, which is roughly 2.5 meters tall. They could make chattering and roaring sounds. Next is Silo's cyborg spider. The cybernetic spiders which fed on power sources made by Silo, a humanoid imperial scientist. At some point in time, the bounty hunter, Shala Mondatha, tried to transport some of these spiders. However, the spiders overtook her ship. Now for Dustweaver spiders, the large spiders with spindly legs found on Tatooine. They nested in the Mos Pig Rise. Next up is Gintho, the giant spiders from Utapo. They had a couple of feathery antennae and eight legs strong enough to walk vertically up sinkholes on Utapo. They produced strong silk which they could wrap and leave their prey in, after which they would drink the remains. Some of these lived in Po City, a city which Poans lived in. In the Battle of Utapo, Gintho created traps to snare separatist battle droids. Next is the Kinraths, giant arachnids found in caves on Dantooine and Kashyyyk. They were venomous and could spin webs. The kyber crystal, the Dantari crystal, could sometimes be found in Kinraath eggs. Now for the knobby white eye spiders, which lived in caves on Maldo Crees. They had a large range in sizes, a head in the center of their bodies, a circular mouth with many teeth, and green blood. In The Mandalorian, the larger spider had eight legs, and the smaller spiders had six. Also, their eggs are tasty. Next up is the knobby white spider, a type of spider which lived on Dagobah. They were similar to the knobby white eye spiders. They could grow into gnarl trees. That's right, a spider growing into a tree. I'm just as confused as you are. Yoda lived in the base of one of these trees. Alright, so looking at the Wikipedia page on gnarl trees, it seems that not all gnarl trees come from spiders. And so my theory is that the trees could implant seeds into the spiders, and the spider would provide nutrients for growth, similar to how the braconid wasp lays eggs in hornworms in the real world. Next is the marsh spider, a species of spider found around swamps on Dagobah. Remind me not to go to Dagobah anytime soon. Now for the Rakazak beasts, a spider-like species native to the forest moon of Endor. They were tamed and ridden by Yuuzhan, which used them when hunting Ruggers. I wouldn't want to be a Rugger and see this running at me. I can't guarantee that the Rakazak beasts are arachnids, but they're close enough for this list. Next up is the Rock Weavers, a species of spider which were native to Loreth. They were found on the mountain Temple Peak and built webs which could be dissolved by certain sound frequencies. Hence, those frequencies would be used to get rid of rock weaver spiders. Next is the solive spiders. They were native to Bassana. Now for spice spiders, a type of spider found on Alof and Tul. Their webs were made from glitter stim, an addictive substance which was banned. They could attack in swarms and actually attacked a group of droids this way at one point in time. Next up is the spine spider, a type of spider native to Pashur, a desert planet. They had poison glands which were used for medical uses. Next is unidentified spider-like creature, a spider-like creature which lived on Dakar. Now for a different unidentified spider-like creature. This spider-like creature was from the planet Kulgrun, a mountainous planet. They had blue skin, were able to reassemble themselves after being blasted, and had red eyes. Lando was attacked by hordes of these spiders. Next up is web weavers, the large spiders native to Kashyyyk. They could devour humans, but that didn't stop the Wookiees from hunting and eating them. In 5ABY, Han and Chewie released a swarm of web weavers on the Imperial Star Destroyer Dominion, which allowed them and their team to make their way to the ship's bridge. Next is the Wisp Spider, a species of spider found on the planet Dauna. They were sometimes seen in the houses of natives. Now for Wreck Weavers, a species of arachnid found on Nelgenum. They ate metal and didn't like bright light. They infested the library of Nelgenum. Next up is the Y-Shock, a species of spider native to Kashyyyk. They were intelligent and could web their prey from a distance. They often ambushed prey from above or below. Adult Y-Shocks could lay 1,000 eggs a year. To protect their eggs, they made egg sacs out of webbing, saliva, and a substance secreted from their lymphatic nodes. When being born, the Y-Shock ate their way out of the egg sac, which could take up to 5 days, leaving them hungry enough to attack anything on sight. Wookiees were taught to defend themselves from Y-Shocks from as early as 3 years old. One subspecies of Y-Shock is the albino Y-Shock, a rare subspecies which were faster, more aggressive, could live for centuries, and could spit venom. They fed off of the brains of their prey. Thank you for watching. I'm glad there aren't so many giant spiders in the real world. And bye.